Yes. Alright. Today we are going to, this is just a quick video. I'm testing out, I have a new light over here. And, I'm testing it out because I'm not going to use that. There's some green tape and t-shirts right there. That's just green tape. I'm scared someone's watching her. Anyways, this is just my Gamecube collection. I can show you my Gamecube if you want, but let me show you my Gamecube collection first. First, you have the obvious, Wind Waker. The obvious Wind Waker. Blockbuster from 2006. Like, November. Or no, not even November, it's January. And, this is what this looks like. And, yes, it's golden. Freaking golden. Everything. So, that's that. And, then we have, this is a promotional disc for Legend of Zelda. And, it's not for reselling. So, I don't plan to sell this at any time. But what this has, this pretty much is, an emulator for NES and Nintendo 64. It has, Legend of Zelda, 2, Ocarina of Time, and Majora's Masks. Masks. And it has a playable demo, I believe 20 minutes of Wind Waker. It also has like some other stuff, like a cutscene and other. This is what the game disc looks like. And, actually, this came, I should have shown you the manuals as well. And, yeah. Probably the weirdest cover ever. This doesn't even snap. So I have to. This? Okay, hold up. Just, judging on what this is, what do you think this is? Take a good guess. It's actually Legend of Zelda again. It's called Legend of Zelda 4 Heroes. GameStop and EB Games, you did like a bad job. And It's rated E. That freaking thing. And this is really bad shape. Really weird shape. But a strange thing is this is like the first called co-op version of Zelda, and surprisingly enough, I have tested it out, and it's the official version. I guess this case was like someone made this, and just put random stuff on it. Who knows? Actually, it looks familiar. It looks like the same cover for Mass Effect 2, or not Mass Effect 2, Dead Rising 2. Anyways, this is the first game I've actually got technically for the GameCube. This was True Crime: Streets of LA. And I got this before I even had my GameCube. So, that's interesting. And, of course, the disc itself. Now, a strange thing is that this was like, really, this is the player's choice. I mean, sure. You know what is also the player's choice? The Sims. The actual Sim itself. And, there's not even a manual in here, it's just a instruction booklet and, like, some other thing to keep you protected. And this is also from Maxis and EA Games. And, here's another thing. This came out in 2004. And, that's what the disc looks like. This disc is, like, so simple. It's like someone made it in, like, PowerPoint. And that's actually all my games I have for the GameCube. And, you probably want to see the main attraction itself, the console. I will show you that in just 1 second. Let me pause the video, and then I'll go get it. Man, it's been a while since I played this. This is my GameCube right here. This memory SD slot, I just had this in here for no reason. But, yeah, it's my GameCube. You have serial port, high-speed port? I haven't even checked this out. Oh, it's one of those. Whatever this is, I guess, colder, but I mean, I can't be colder. Has all your normal average day stuff. Has the analog AV out. It's the whole latch ring. Yeah. I think this is important enough. Now, this is it. There's nothing in it. I'm using some a little bit. It's heavy. I'll give you that. I'll give you that any day. And then my little screen back display. Now, obviously it's not actually like that. I have the stuff for it. But anyways, here's my controller I used to use for this. And by used to use, I meant like maybe 2 days before I realized it was a better controller. This came with my box. Yeah, but I mean, it's a good controller and all, but the Z button barely works. It barely works. One of the joysticks doesn't even have like a protector. That one does. D-pad does this. It like makes a snappy noise when you try to play with it. A, B are stiff. And you have to press Y like that. But anyways, I also got this in with me, and this is a slightly better controller. I can see someone using this back in the day. This is this is from Mad Catz, as well as the memory card, as I've been shown. If I've already shown that. Okay, wait, this actually feels better to me, because the GameCube is already good enough as it is. But this feels like they mixed like an Xbox or PlayStation controller into the mix. And you have Z, and then you also have M, which I have no idea what that does. But anyways, you have the good old joystick. Makes sense. D-pad's still a little stiff, but it's understandable. Macro button, I'm guessing that's for Game Boy Advance stuff. And it just feels like all around better controller. And if I'm really into a good game, I get to do this. Yeah. And I probably went a little overboard. But that's just my GameCube collection. Just wanted to show it as a test for this lighting. For new videos. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I guess I'll see you later. I don't know. Maybe I'll see you later Saturday. I'll make one video somewhere. I have nothing to do, dude. I'm gonna go bye-bye.